Good morning, here I am, second day at the lake. Absolutely flat calm. Yesterday was a burster. I actually lost count of the amount of trout that I caught. So let's see what we can do today. I'm fishing an intermediate line, which is a very slow sink. And judging by yesterday, you don't have to put out a long cast. But then yesterday was another day. It was later on in the day. This is first thing this morning. So it could be a totally different kettle of fish. Excuse the expression. There's a couple of other anglers here today. I'm obviously here again with Juan Manuel. And so far it seems as if they are a little bit deeper, so I'll have to wait a little while longer before we make the retrieve. A couple of tugs just to straighten out the line. Often those two tugs will entice a reaction, but on this occasion, no. Just counting down to 10. Juan Manuel is into his first fish over there. He was just saying that the colour orange is what's caught, but I know how successful that can be. And I don't want to start so quickly. There's a rise just there. Let's have a see if I can create a bit of interest. No. Okay, back to plan A. Couple of tugs, straighten out the line. Count to 15. He says they're not as high as they were yesterday. Just doing some quick tugs, pause, a couple more. Sometimes the pause can create some interest. There's fish on the surface, but I don't know whether they're feeding or just doing their thing. It's due to cloud up a little bit later on, but at the moment the sun is up and it's a fine day. Cast a little bit to the left. Right, that's the first fish. They're not very big, but they certainly have a good tussle on them. Right, that's the first one in the net. Put the rod down. And hopefully take out the fly, which is a little black leech. Chinese people behind me asking me what I've caught, and they thought, have I caught pike?
Sí, sí, muy limpia. Y baja el nivel también.
Tugs to straighten out the line. And some sharp pulls back.
Hasta luego. Pasen buen día.
Maybe the trout are waiting for the water to warm up, who knows? Into his second fish there. After yesterday's tumultuous day, I took well over 20 trout. I was almost frightened to come back today. Right, I think it's time for a change of fly. I'll put something different on the point. I've put on a small orange mop fly on the point. See if we get any interest. Start pulling straight away and see if we have any interest, and then slowly go deeper. Yes, instant interest and a fish. Come on, my friend. Keep your nose up. Up. Look at that, beached. Right. So, instant success. Corner of the mouth there. Perfect. As you saw, instant success with the mop fly, although it's not a big mop fly. I'll have another go. Right. Try a figure of eighting back. Just pause. They certainly don't want it slow by the looks of it. I'll give it to them a bit faster then, if that's what they want. Didn't want it a bit faster either. They want it a bit deeper. Couple of tugs, straighten the line. Just count it to 10. Sharp pull back. Letting it sink a little bit. Some slow pulls back.
Sí.
Oh, I was just saying that they are lower than they were yesterday. They were quite close to the surface yesterday. Right, one more cast with this line and then I'm going to change. Straighten the line. Right. I've allowed that to go a little bit deeper. Come to nothing. So, change of line is required. Right, and now with the heavy stuff, I'm on a 6 with a couple of small boobies. A couple of tugs, straighten out the leader. Letting it go down a little bit. Sorry, that was the basket just hitting the camera. Straight away. Certainly much deeper today. Looks like the black booby. Couple of tugs. Let it sink a little and it will sink fairly fast. Being a 6. Some long sharp pulls. Slow, just mixing it up a little bit. Maybe the six is too heavy, going down too quick, going below them. So I'll give it a change, I think. I'll turn to a sink tip. I'm going to try with a couple of nymphs first, see how we get on. Slowly figure of eight back. I think it'll take a couple of casts for the sink tip to get underway. I'm going to change your fly on the point. I'll keep the nymph above. Right, I've put a long fibre fritz on the point and a nymph on the dropper. Well, this doesn't seem to be working very well either. So I think I'll go onto a floating line and just sit it out with a couple of nymphs or buzzers. Alright, let's see how we get on. Right, so I've put on a floating line and a couple of sort of nymph buzzers, or buzzer nymphs, whichever you like to look at. They've got little tails on, and see how we get on. I haven't got a long leader on, it's probably, I say tippet really, it's only about 8 feet. about 2.5 meters, I suppose. Maybe I need something on the point as an attractor instead of just the nymph. I'd have put on a 6 again and just give it a couple of tugs to straighten out the leader. Right, let it sink. I don't know whether this is a fish or the bottom. I think it's a fish the way it's moving around. So the sinking line has done it.
Depth with the fly, changing the lines regularly, continued to catch at intervals. So that was quite testing, and it allowed us to learn just a little bit more. We will be returning at some time, and I certainly will be returning, I hope, to the community championships. When I say community, it's like the state championships. So that's something to look forward to. Maybe I'll get another trip in before that. But great couple of days, learning a great deal, and I hope that you have enjoyed the little snippets that I've put together for you. And you've seen a few fish, I've seen a few fish, so we should all be happy. Thanks for viewing, and I'll